Hello, and welcome back to another Keep Moving with Emily. I'm so glad that you're joining me today. We are going to do an awesome 30-minute workout. We're going to get a full body workout in. We're going to do strength, cardio, core. We're going to be doing 3 different rounds, lots of different exercises. It's going to be super fun. As always, if you are able to stand unassisted, or even using like a chair or couch, I encourage you, anytime we can stand to do exercises, it's always a good thing. But if today is not your day, feeling a little fatigued or your legs are tired or standing is just not an option for you, you can do this whole workout seated. I'm going to show you both of those versions throughout the whole workout. At the end of the day, I want you to keep moving, listen to your body. You know how to listen to it and know what's going to feel good to you. So today's theme is what my shirt says, unstoppable. I want you to be unstoppable today. Some of the music that I'm playing hopefully will encourage you as we get this workout on. So the type of equipment that I need for you to grab, I've got a couple sets of different weights. Sometimes as we do longer periods of like strength, our muscles might start getting fatigued, and so you can always drop your weights. So I've got some lighter weights and a little bit heavier weights. And if you don't have any weights at all, that's okay. You can always use water bottles or even tent. I also have a chair, I have a fan going, and always make sure you have water. It's important to hydrate. Like any workout, we always wanna do a warm up. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna start seated, but if you want, you are welcome to stand. But I'm glad you're here. If you're seated, always remember, plant those feet flat on the ground, sitting up nice and tall, always engage your core. Check in with that core throughout the whole workout. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, let's take a big breath in, up to the sky, and exhale. Nice, big breath in again. And exhale. Last one, big breath in. And exhale. We're gonna warm up from our head to our toes. Let's start with some shoulder rolls backwards. Very nice. Opening up that chest, opposite direction. Very nice. We're gonna wake up that body, get it moving. I'll swing those arms up nice and high to the ceiling and down. Big breath in as you reach up and exhale. Last one and exhale. Nice. Open up and cross it over. Good. Always good to get that chest open. Good. Keep it up. There's no such thing as impossible. Good. All right, shake out those arms. Let's reach it up and over. Get a nice stretch in those obliques. Good. Side of the body. Keep that core nice and tight. If you've joined me before, warm-ups kind of seem pretty similar. That's why we wanna warm up our body. From the head to the toes, that's why it might look a little similar, but that is okay. Dynamic warm-ups are important. Let's do a little bit of spinal twist. You can always push those arms across. Good. Warm up our spine. Check in with that core. Very nice. A couple more. Very nice. Last two. Good. We're gonna extend one foot out, and we're gonna do those hamstring scoops. Heels in the ground, toes pointed up. We're reaching and scooping those arms. Feel a nice stretch in the back of that leg as we get those arms up and back. Let's switch it up. So other leg extend, heels in the ground, toes pointed up. Great. And scoop. Keeping that core nice and tight. Try to keep your back flat as you move forward. A nice stretch in the hamstring. Warm up those legs. Good. All right, if you're able to, we're gonna march it out, driving those knees up. If that doesn't work for you, you can always grab one leg and bring it up. Good. Warming up those hip flexors a little bit, warming up the core. Good, and we're pumping those arms. We're gonna do leg extensions, kicking that foot out, squeezing the top of the leg. Good. Now, if you're doing all of this standing, kind of the same idea. You're just kind of kicking that leg out. But if balance is an issue, you can always hang on to something or stay with us seated. We'll get standing in a little bit. Good. Nice. Let's do some calf raises. Up onto those toes, rock it back onto the heels, warming up the front of our leg, that shin part, and the calf. Good. Very nice. We're almost done. Good. Let's do a couple more arm crosses. Warming up those arms some more, those shoulders. We'll be using them today. And reach it up nice and high. Inhale. Exhale. All right, shake it out. Blood should be pumping. I'm going to turn my music off real quick and explain how it's going to work. Each round is going to seem pretty similar. So after I go through the first one, you'll kind of get the idea. So we're always going to start off with strength. We're going to be doing a minute of each of these exercises. This is going to work a little bit in endurance. So the first exercise is the strength one. So here are two options. So for those of you who are seated, this is where we're going to be. You're going to sit down and you're going to extend one foot out, squeeze, place that foot back down to the ground to a shoulder press, then alternate legs. So a leg extension with a shoulder press. If you want a little bit more of a challenge, you do the same thing. So leg with arms, kick, leg with arms. So either of those are really great options for seated. If you are standing, your option is a sit to stand. So we're gonna stand, press it up, wait to come back to those shoulders, and you're gonna sit in that chair, stand it up, and press. So you're either doing a sit to stand with a shoulder press, or you're doing a seated leg extension with a shoulder press. We're going for a full minute. We're gonna go nice, slow, and controlled, so nothing too crazy, nothing too fast. We're gonna kind of be getting a full body workout with those legs and the arms. Make sure your core is nice and tight. If you are doing a sit to stand with me, make sure that those knees are at 90 degrees, weights are up at our shoulder, engage that core, push through those heels, squeezing through the glutes, and press it up nice and high, all right? That's what we'll be doing for that first minute. Now, for our cardio, what we're gonna be doing are just good old punches. So whether you're seated or standing, same thing. We're gonna go single, single, and then four quick ones. Single, single, then one, two, three, four. Good old punches for a whole minute. This is a great way to get your cardio up. If you're standing, we're just gonna be here. Single, single, one, two, three, four. All right? You can always, you know, do a little bit of sidestep, you know, or squats, whatever. Just as long as you keep moving, you can always shift your weight back and forth. That's gonna be our strength. And then for our core, we're gonna be alternating between penguins, reaching down, working those obliques, and then bicycle curls, opposite elbow, opposite knee. You are standing, we're here, reaching down, keeping that core nice and tight, and then opposite elbow, opposite knee. I'll make sure to remind you, but we're gonna be kind of going quick through all of these, twice through. You'll catch on. We got this, you've got this, we are unstoppable today. So, without further ado, let's get moving. I'm gonna turn my timer on. We have about 10 seconds to get started. All right, grab those weights. You're either doing that sit to stand with that shoulder press, or you're here with me with that seated leg extension. Here we go. So we're gonna press, kick that leg out. If you're seated, if doing both at the same time is too hard, you can always just extend with a press. If we're standing, here. Good. Really make sure you breathe. Exhale here. Nice. So whatever version feels good to you today, that's what I want you to do. Nice and slow. Good. Press. We're seated. We're here. Squeezing that quad. If the legs don't work for you today, if that is not for you, just good old shoulder presses. Nice. Core is nice and tight. Or we're extending with a press. 15 seconds to go. You got it. Keep it up. You want to try one of those sit to stands? Go for it. Make sure you stay safe. That's my only thing. Good. Rest. We're going into those punches for a minute. Here we go. Ready. And begin. So single, single, then quick four. One, 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 two, three, four. Good. Good. If that's too confusing, you can just punch it out. Good. If we're standing, kind of sink it into those legs a little bit. Good. Keep that core nice and tight. If you're having a bad day, take it out right now. Good. Or you're here. Good. Keep it up. Again, if we're seated right here, we're more than halfway done. Single, quick four. Good. You can always reach across the body, engage that core a little bit more. After this, we're moving on to the core with those penguins and bicycles. Good. And time. Get ready for those penguins. We're going penguins for 30 seconds. Sitting up nice and tall, engage the core. Reach one hand down here. If you're seated, keeping that core tight, you should feel it right here. Like you're trying to pretend to pick something up. If you're standing, we're here. Keep it tight. Good. Don't forget to breathe. So important. 10 more seconds here, and then we're moving on to those bicycles. Opposite elbow to opposite knee, whether you're seated or standing. I'm gonna start with standing. Here we go. Opposite elbow, opposite knee. If this challenges your balance, go seated for me here, twisting across the body, driving that knee up. If that's too hard, sit nice and tall and twist. 15 seconds to go, and then we're gonna go back to the top with those sit to stand shoulder presses or leg extension with shoulder presses. Straight into it. Good, 3, 2, 1. Grab those weights. Back to those sit to stands. Got it. Here we go, I'm starting with those standing options. So we're gonna stand, squeeze the glutes, press. Sit down nice and slow. Core is tight, press. Again, if you're seated, you can either do legs with arms or extend, then press, or leave out the legs. Whatever works for you. Good work. About 30 seconds to go. Full body workout here. I'm already working up a sweat. I'm sure you are too. Don't forget to breathe. Keep that core nice and tight. We gotta protect that lower back as we press those weights up to the sky. Good, or we're seated. You can either have those wrists face each other or out wide, whatever feels good to you. You can always drop one weight if it gets too heavy. Last 5 seconds, here we go. Woo, and rest. We're going to those punches. You just punch it out or go single, quick four. You ready? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, punch. Good. If that's too confusing for your brain, you can just punch it or go across the body or go up high. I don't care. You do you. Again, if we're standing, we can be here. Shifting that weight a little bit. Nice. You got it. Today, we are unstoppable. Super important to figure out what that intention is. What is your why? Is it to keep moving, to get healthier, to keep running with those kiddos, whatever it is that makes you unstoppable today. Good job. We're almost finished. Last 10 seconds, but you won't see these punches again. Good. Nice. 3, 2, 1. We're moving on to that core. So you're doing those penguins first for 30 seconds. If you're standing with me, sink a little bit into the squat. Reach for that knee, reach. Keeping that core nice and tight. Bringing that rib to the hip. Stay here if you're standing. For those seated, same thing. We're just reaching down, almost like you're trying to touch the floor. Keeping that core engaged the whole time. 15 more seconds here, and then we're moving on to those bicycles. Opposite elbow to opposite knee. Good. And let's switch to those. Opposite elbow, opposite knee. I like this song. We are unstoppable, aren't we? Good work. If we're standing, twisting across the body, this really requires a lot of balance and stability. So, you know what you can do? Stay safe. 5 seconds to go. Good. Good. Two and one. Nice job. All right. Woo. Let's put a pause on that real quick. All right, we're moving on to round two. Same idea, one strength, one cardio, one core, twice through a minute of each, all right? So this is what's gonna look like. We're doing 21, so this is a bicep curl. So this is how it's gonna work. We're gonna do seven bottom half biceps. So I'm bringing the weights all the way down to the side and only up halfway. We're calling for seven. And then once we get to seven, we're going from half up to the top. So we're bending up to the top for seven and then seven full curls. As long as you stay with me, you'll stay on track. And if you're standing, same thing. If you were able to stand, anytime we can stand to do an exercise, the better. So while I'm talking, you can like march in place or sidestep just to keep moving. All right, so again, half for seven, bottom half, top half for seven, and then full. You'll catch on to that one. All right, the next one, we're gonna do a little bit more bicep curls, but this is gonna be a little bit of cardio. So we're curling the arm across the body. We're going for eight counts here, and then we're gonna go eight reaches. All right, so little or standing, you're gonna go one, two, for eight, and then reach for eight. On repeat for a minute. All right, then we're doing Russian twists. So for those of you who are seated with me, you can grab a weight or no weight at all, that's up to you. Slight lean, and I'm just reaching from one side to the other for eight. You're gonna feel this in those obliques as you twist and twist. If you are standing, you can just kind of twist as you stand. And then we're gonna go a seated knee tuck or a seated knee crunch. So here, squeeze and squeeze. If you're standing, same thing, same here. Cool. So that is what our round is going to look like. So grab those weights. We're doing those 21 curls. 10 seconds. We'll get started. Here we go. All right. 10 seconds. We'll get started. We're starting on that bottom half of that bicep curl. You ready? And so just going down to halfway up. One. Two, three, don't forget to breathe. Four, five, six, last one, seven. Now hang here. One, two, keep it up. Three, four, five, six, seven. Now we're going for a full bicep curl for seven. Good. Six, five, four, good, three, two, one, from the top, one, two, good, three, woo, feel the burn, four, five, six, seven, here we go, seven, six, five, woo, rest, nice job, get into that cardio, eight, curls, eight reaches. So staying with me. So here's eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Reach it up. Good. You can count on your own if you want to go slower, you want to go faster, or if you're seated for eight. You can tap that foot out or just stay here. Good. I've already lost count. So if you're with me, you may end up doing more. Good. Hang with it. You can even go 10, you can go five, whatever works for you. Curl it up, good. This works our core. Get that cardio up. Three, two, one, reach it up. If you're standing, we're here. Anything, I just want you to keep moving. You can kind of feel the music. Play with it, have fun. Reach three, two, and one. We're doing those crunches, so Russian twists. You can either be standing, twisting across, or we're here. We're here for 30 seconds, and then we're doing that single knee tuck. Good, again, the side, it looks like this. twisting across the body, keeping my core nice and tight. Got 15 seconds to go if we're standing. Nice little twist. Bringing that weight to the hip. Keep the core nice and tight. Protect that lower back. Good. You're feeling this in that core if you keep nice and tight. Good. And drop that weight. We're going knee here. Driving that knee straight forward, almost doing like a standing crunch. If you're seated, we're here. Driving that knee up. If that's too much, you can do a good old sit up. Good. Working that core. Let's go. 10 seconds to go. Don't forget to breathe. Exhale as you bring that knee up. Inhale as you come down. And rest. We are going to do those curls again. Let's start with 7 full curls here. Here we go. Begin for 7. 6. 5. You got it. 4. 3. 2. And 1. We're starting at the bottom half for 7. Only bringing it halfway up. Good. Stand up real quick. 3. Good. 4. 5. Keep it up. 6. 7. Now from halfway, we're going up to those shoulders. Back to halfway. Good. For 7. 4. 3. 2. 1. Full 7. Here we go. Keep that core nice and tight. Nice, slow, and controlled. Think about what muscles we're working. How those biceps. You're doing good. 2 more. Woo. Woo. Let's do bottom half for a few. 3, 2, 1. Drop those weights. Cardio time. Again, 8 curls. Here we go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Reach it up across the body. Reach. Here's 6, 7, 8 curls for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're reaching. 6, 7, 8. You got it. Nice. Whatever version feels good to you, whether you're doing these little side ones, maybe we're just reaching across the body, not incorporating the legs. That's what happens when I talk and try to count. It's hard. Good, we got 10 seconds to go. Keep it up, keep it up. Finish strong. 3, 2, 1. Russian twists. 30 seconds here. Kind of lean back just a tad. And then twist, almost like you're bringing that weight to that hip. Good. My back is up off the chair. Slightly leaning back. You're gonna feel in that core. Feel in the obliques, those side abs. Keep it up, keep it up. If we're standing, nice little twist. Core is nice and tight, bringing that weight to that hip. 9 seconds, and then we're moving on to the single knee tucks. If you want to go hardcore, you can keep with this weight. I'll show you. So we're going to bring those arms up, crunch, and crunch. If you want that harder one, you can always drop the weight. Or if you want to go hardcore seated, you can do hardcore seated. If that doesn't work for you, drop that weight, driving that knee up, keep your arms high, and crunch. Good. It ain't over yet. Let's go. Keep moving. Whatever version feels good. You keep moving. 3, 2, 1. Woo. Nice job. Okie dokie. We are moving on. We're on to round 3. See, having fun. It goes by super fast. Okay. You can stick with those heavy weights. You may want to have light weights handy because the muscles we're going to be working in our shoulders and our chest, they might be a little bit not as strong. They're not like a huge major muscle group. And so you might fatigue a lot quicker. So make sure you have some light weights handy. If it gets too much, you can always just go no weight at all. So we're doing a lateral raise, slight bend in the elbows, arms come up no higher than our shoulders. So parallel to the ground. And then we're going to bring the weights together, squeezing in the chest. Out to the side and down. So lateral raise, almost like a chest fly, chest press. That's what that one's going to look like. You can do it standing, kind of in a bit of a squat, working the tops of those shoulders a little bit in the traps, and then in the chest as we bring those weights together. All right. So I call these my fireball arms for our cardio. We're going to work the triceps, the back of that arm. So, you know, when you wave your arms, you want to tighten this area up. This is my fireball arm. So extend one arm, squeezing in the back of this arm, and change. So here, you can kind of shake those hips if you're standing, squeezing in the back of the arm. Again, we're going to do 8 count or 10, whatever feels good to you. I may end up losing count. So we're going to do 8 for here, and then 8 rope climbs, reaching down, driving that elbow down for 8. If we're standing, if you want to kind of go hardcore, you can jog in place. Make it fun, make it yours. You know what you are able to do. All right, for our core, this is what it's going to look like. We're going to be doing a knee tuck if you're seated. So slightly leaning back, driving those knees up and down. Again, you can stick with that single knee if that is too much for you. Again, while I'm talking, march in place, keep moving. If we're standing, we can go again to that bicycle or single knee core, or if you want to do a toy soldier where your leg is extended, up to you. 30 seconds of knee tucks, and then our last one, we're going to be doing kind of like a triangle. So this is with weight or no weight at all. We're going to keep the arms out. We're going to draw a triangle. Once you do a full one, go the opposite side. So it's going to work the core as we're twisting, also working the arms. If we're seated, out, up, down, out, and then change. If it gets too heavy, you can always drop that weight and just bring those arms. You should feel it in that core. All right? And that's going to finish out our workout. We're going to do 2 rounds of that. So you got it. We're going to move. Here we go. All right. 10 seconds. We're going to start with those lateral raises. Try the heavy weights out if that's too much for a minute. And drop it to lower ones. Here we go. So we're doing that lateral raise. Up. Weights come together. Squeeze in the chest. Out and down. I have a slight bend in my elbow. Good. It ain't over yet. Nice. Good. We're here for a minute. About 40 seconds to go if you're standing. Again, slight bend in the knees. You're gonna feel this in a little bit in the back too. Tops of those shoulders. Chest and back. Keep it up. Hold on to it. Strong shoulders, strong core. Let's go. You got this. 20 seconds. Hang on to it. Again, if that gets too heavy, you can always drop it down. I feel it in those shoulders. Woo! Breathe it out. Keep it up. Tone up those arms right here, right now. 5 seconds. I'm there with you. Feel the burn. 3, 2, 1. Drop those arms. Time for some fireball arms. Again, we're extending here for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Reach it up and rope climb. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms are out. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hang on to it. Got 30 seconds to go. Squeezing in the back of that arm. Good. And up. Woo. Feel that burn in the shoulders. You can always march in places we're seated. And out to the side. Hang on to it. It ain't over yet. Woo. Maybe this song is, but we're not done yet. Feel burning those shoulders. Hang on to it. Kind of do whatever version feels good to you. Reach and out to the side. 3, 2, 1. Woo, shake it out. We're going into that knee tuck seated, or you're doing that standing, you can either do a standing bicep curl or standing bicycle or a toy soldier. Good. If this is too hard, single knees. If that's too much, good old sit up. Keep it up. 10 seconds to go, and then we're moving in to that triangle. So grab one of those weights. We're gonna be drawing a triangle, keeping that core nice and tight. Hang on to it. And I'm gonna stand up for this one. All right, out to the side. Up. So I'm standing. Once you finish that triangle, opposite direction. Good. Core is nice and tight. Squeezing those glutes if you're standing. If we're seated, we're here. Good. 10 seconds to go. Still working those shoulders. Woo! Nice. Last triangle. And drop it. Woo! Actually, you're gonna grab those weights. I'm gonna drop mine. It's a little bit lighter one. Lateral raise. Come into that chest press or chest fly and down. Again, if the weights get too heavy, you can always drop them. Good. Breathe, core is tight. If we're standing, we're here. Maybe sink it into a little bit of a squat, bend those knees, bring those hips back. Working the tops of those shoulders. Chest a little bit in that back as you bring those elbows back. Nice. Last 30 seconds, you've got it. If you need to stop and shake out those arms real quick or drop those weights too and keep going, you do that. Feels good to get this body moving. You got it. Exhale and inhale. Don't forget to breathe. Good. Last 7 seconds. Hang on to it. Come on. 3, 2, 1. Let's get those fireball arms, shall we? I'm gonna start seated. Shake out those arms. Here we go. Have fun with it. You can march in place, squeezing in the back of that arm, and then rope climb. If you need to go slower, you go slower. If you need to go faster, pick it up a notch. Let's go. Good. And then out to the side. You can count 8. You can count 10, or once you kind of get tired of this one, you change it up. If you're standing here, we can even jog it out. If you really want hardcore, that's up to you. Have fun with it. I mean, if exercise isn't fun, we're not going to stick with it, right? Good. Keep it up. You got 20 seconds. What can you do these last 20 seconds? You got it. Come on. If that's too much, you can just shake it or dance it out or march it out. If your arms are too tired, punch it out. Whatever feels good to you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're going for those knee tucks here. I'm gonna do them standing with y'all. Here we go. So we can even come here. Or if you wanna go toy soldier, squeezing opposite arm to opposite toe. You can stay there or with me. You can do it seated if you wanna give it a try. Last 15 seconds for this one. And then we're finishing with that triangle. Good. Or knee tucks or double knee tucks. Nice. 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab that weight. We're moving on to that triangle. Out, up, down, and out. Good. We're not gonna quit. No way. This is our last bit. Hang on to it. Last 15 seconds. Wherever you're at, don't stop. Don't quit. You are unstoppable. Yes, you are. That is your mantra for today. And nice. Oh man. I don't know about you, but my arms are on fire, but it feels so good. Grab some water real quick. Sorry, I forgot to remind you to grab water throughout this whole workout, but you're doing awesome. I say we bring this heart rate down just a little bit. We'll breathe for a couple of rounds and then we'll stretch it out and call it a day. So I'm gonna find some calm music real quick. Here we go. So let's calm that breath down. Inhale nice and big. Hold it up at the top, breathe. Slowly breathe it out. Nice, one more big breath in. Fill up those lungs, hold it up at the top, and exhale. Last one, big breath in, nice and slow, fill up those lungs. Hold for 4, three, two, one. Exhale. Nice. Let's just kind of shoulder rolls back. Three. Roll those shoulders forward. Open up nice and big. You can either open it up or grab behind your chair. Lifting the chest up to the sky. Let's exhale forward, rounding that back a little bit. And then inhale, open up that chest. And exhale. Let's stretch it out from our head to our toes. So start with that neck. So bring your left ear to left shoulder. Extend right arm out. Play with the angle of your chin. Sometimes we might get like a weird electric zing if that happens. Don't do that. Good. Take a big breath in. Exhale, slowly roll the chin. Bring the other ear to the other shoulder. So right ear to right shoulder, extend that arm. Play with the angle of that chin. Get a nice stretch in your neck. Good. Big breath in. It comes back to neutral and exhale. Get a nice little spinal twist. So we're gonna twist, bringing opposite arm to that knee, opening up our chest to the other side. Just learned something really interesting. If you have any like digestive issues, twisting like this really helps. It's helpful. If you ever have that issue, nice little spinal twist can help with that. Sit up nice and tall, opening up that chest and breathing. Big breath in. And as we exhale, twist to the other side. Good. Hopefully if you're standing or seated with us, please do this on the floor if you want to as well. Really breathe. Feel that chest nice and open, a little twist and stretch in that spine. Good breath in. Exhale, that's nice. I'm gonna place my left arm onto my chair. Big breath in with that right arm. And as I exhale, I'm gonna reach it up and over, stretching out those obliques. Making a C, reaching that hand to that opposite wall. You should really feel a stretch in the lats and in your obliques. Good, big breath in, reaching that arm up. Exhale, arm comes down. Place that right hand on your chair, left arm up, big breath in, and exhale, reach it up and over. You should feel really good right now, knowing that you took just about 30 minutes out of your day to take care of yourself, get some endorphins going. Big breath in, reach that hand up, and exhale. Let's bring one arm across the body. You know, research says that we should be getting exercise 150 minutes a week. You break that out into 5 days, it's about 30 minutes a day. So congratulations, you can check that off your list of today because you did that. Nice job. Just as a little bit of encouragement, open up those arms nice and big. Exhale, bring the other arm across. Sometimes 30 minutes consecutively just does not work for you, whether it's time, fatigue, not feeling it. You can always break that up too throughout the day. 10 minutes here, 10 minutes in the afternoon, 10 minutes in the evening. So it doesn't have to be consecutive for it to still count. So be encouraged by that. Some of us on our health journey, that's just not it for us right now, and that's okay. Let's stretch out that tricep. So I'm bringing one arm up, bending at the elbow, patting myself on the back, and then kind of gently pulling on that elbow. If that's too much, we can stay here. Good, those fireball arms. Work those triceps, switch arms. think health journeys are so complex. There's so many different challenges that we may face. And so I just want you to feel encouraged to know that to give yourself grace sometimes, it is okay if you're not able to get it done that day. Let's stretch out those legs. So heel on the ground, toes pointed up. Same movement as that hamstring. Scoop, or just leaning forward. Pull that toe towards you. Get a little bit more in that calf. Reach for that shin, ankle, or toe to really get the rip back of that hamstring. Or you can just stay here. Yeah. I think my pieces of encouragement are always to celebrate your little victories, whatever that looks like, whatever your goals are. Start off small. Celebrate those victories. Give yourself grace. Every day looks different. Some days we have good days, other days we have bad days. And that is okay. And then just keep moving, you know? Bring that knee up, bring that ankle on top, and lean it forward. And breathe. That's a good stretch for the hip, the glutes. Ooh. But if anything, know that I am super proud of you for joining me today, getting that body moving, grooving. I hope you feel unstoppable, seeing as that was my theme for the day. Good. Ooh, I could sit here all day. Let's bring that foot down. Let's go the opposite leg. Extend that foot out. Toes in the ground. Pull that toe towards your chest. Bring it towards you. Oh, feel good. Stretch in the back of that hamstring and reach. And breathe. We're not done yet, so this is still your sacred time. It's a nice special time just for you. Good. All right, grab that leg. Let's place it up on top. Ankle on top of that knee and lean forward. I'm kind of gently pressing on this knee a little bit to get a little bit deeper into that hip. If you're on the floor, sometimes if you're laying on the ground, you can always kind of hug your leg kind of towards your chest too, if that's where you're at. Good. All right, let's place that leg on the floor. We're gonna do one forward fold. So I want you to inhale those arms up nice and tall. Almost into that extended mountain pose. And we're gonna exhale, fold it forward. Reach those fingertips to the ground. Let your head hang heavy. If you get dizzy with your head being this low, you can always just stay here so that you don't get too dizzy. But if you're down here, kind of reach underneath that chair if you're able to, or sway back and forth, or go from one side to the other. This feels good in that lower back. You're gonna feel it in those shoulder blades, maybe even a little bit in that inner thigh. Good. Place those hands on top of the thighs, push through the palms, roll up one vertebrae at a time. Head coming up last so we don't get dizzy. One more big breath in up to the sky. Exhale. And give yourself a hand. Awesome job today. Thanks for joining me. I hope you join me again. You can join me for this one. There's tons of other videos available for you, but I'm so glad that you joined me, and know that today you are unstoppable. See you next time.